So a lot of you might have remembered the story when years ago Wendy and I went away to Bude. I took all this gear with me, including the Acom 2000, because I told her we needed the amplifier because the C attenuated the signal, so I needed the amplifier to boost it back up. It was a complete lie. It meant that we actually had to take two cars on holiday, Acom 2000, all the gear and everything else. Because actually the C gives you up to 10 dBs of extra gain. It's a huge amount, and I can prove it to you in software anyway. I mean, I've proved it, you know, I've been done enough operating by the C to know that it really will work. But I'm just building a basic vertical. Wire one base for 7.2 megahertz, whatever, it doesn't matter. So on your average ground, right, 16 radials, and I can tell you all this is just your average ground for growing your potatoes on, whatever else. We should get a reasonable SWR on this, but I'm showing you the far field plots, look. Okay, so this is roughly what I've got at Holly Farm. So that's why everybody can hear me, because in the main, I'm around about probably, Germany's probably there. Hang on. 0.4, can you see it there at the top? 0.4 dBi, and maybe down to here for someone a little bit further, Cyprus, that's 0.5. And then when I go DX, it could be on 40 or 20 meters, it's the same result. It says here minus 5.4. Sounds a bit crap, doesn't it? But minus 5.4 is getting me New Zealand, Australia, you know, across the Atlantic regularly on my Friday live streams, midday, 12 o'clock UTC. Fine. So if I change the ground setup to, this is called millisiemens per meter, but it's basically 5 siemens per meter would be 5,000 millisiemens per meter. You'll notice that my minus five, when I go to the far field plot now, because I'm right by the beach, you know, within probably a couple of wavelengths, okay, and I come down to minus five here, which is there, 4.5 dBi, and I was at minus 5.5, so there's 10 dB. That's 10 dB. It's incredible. So you're 10 watts down, so you go, you know, you get a little, 705, a little bit of coax, DX Commander Expedition, down by the cliff top by the sea, put it up, you know, prop it up on a branch or whatever else, transmit on 1420. You'll be the equivalent, because 10 dB, it's like 10 times the power, remember, 10 dB. 3 dB is double, 3 dB is double again. 3 dB is double again, you get to 9, but 10 is 10, right? Remember where decibels came from. All right, the standard cable mile 100 years ago that Bell Laboratories, or whatever the company was called there, it was Bell, when a customer would notice a substantial decrease in the line, they would call that one bell. All right, over the years, they realized you needed more granularity. So they had a decibel, deci bell, small d for deci, 10, Latin, big B for bell. So you're getting 10 dB. So your 100, your 10 watt radio is now 100 watts, which is why when Tom, he went around the Isle of Arran with a 705, it was 705, that's right. And he was from the Isle of Arran, north of Scotland, you know. His best GX, I think, was Argentina on 20. That's because it was like, because he was right by the sea, it was like him running 100 watts. Okay, so these guys that have got, you know, towers and stuff by the sea, okay, it's like they're looking out across a copper sheet. It's amazing. Multiple wavelengths, you see. Fantastic. By the way, I've noticed that works in reverse, okay? I guess there's salt water under the ground as well. Well, I've normally, when I'm in Bude, North Cornwall, America is right across the sea. But VK, ZL, short path anyway, is the other way. But I often do better, VK and ZL, going inland as well, you know, when I'm transmitting. So I think, you know, experience has told me that just by being by the sea, we'll get you all directions. So there we are. Go on holiday or get a day out down by the sea. Right, pond water, by the way, is completely different. It's just like grow your potatoes in it, all right? And by the way, your radials, don't sink them under the ground, under the water. They still need to be on top of the water, all right? You know, if you've got a pontoon or something, you can float them out maybe, but try and get them actually just on the ground, not under the water. It doesn't work so well. I've read all the documentation. I think that was Rudy Seven. In fact, I must drop Rudy Seven an email, see if we can get him on the channel, because there's 1,000 questions I'd love to ask Rudy. Interesting though, isn't it? All right, next video is coming up here. See you on the next one. Bye for now.